At Chief Buildings, we engineer and manufacture metal building systems just like this for companies and individuals all over Nebraska and the country. But how is it made?
Every structure manufactured at Chief Buildings is custom built for the exact geographic location and its specific end use. After a building is meticulously designed by the engineers, it's sent out to the drafting department for them to create fabrication and erection drawings. These fabrication drawings are sent to the manufacturing plant's computers to begin the process. Once the manufacturing process begins, it takes about 2 weeks in the plant to complete a typical project. Every building starts with literally tons of domestically sourced raw materials. We will start first by showing you how the primary structural members, or rigid frames, are manufactured. Tapered columns and rafters like this, which are unique in the metal building industry, are comprised of three plates of steel. The top flange, the bottom flange, and the middle web are all welded together to form an eye shape. Computer-controlled plasma cutters are used to shape the asymmetrical web pieces, while flanges are formed from uniformly dimensioned flat stock. After each piece is accurately cut for size and bolt holes added, they are first manually tack welded into place by the machine operator and then fed through a highly automated submerged arc welder that can simultaneously finish weld both flanges to the web in one pass. Despite so much automation, there are still several parts of the welding process that must be done manually by our experienced welders, such as adding stiffeners, connection plates, or mounting tabs. Secondary framing members, such as the roof purlins and wall girts, are made from very heavy coils of raw steel. The steel is decoiled, cut to length, and holes are punched before passing through a dedicated roll former. The series of progressive dies are interchanged to create the various C and Z-shaped members that are needed. Unless special finishes are required, all the primary and secondary structural members go through the Electrocoat primer process. This E-coat process is an industry exclusive to Chief Buildings. Here the members are dipped into the primer solution and an electrical current is applied which bonds the primer particles to the metal pieces. The parts are then removed from the tank, rinsed of excess primer, and then sent through an oven for about 30 minutes to cure the primer. This step creates a durable finish for the construction process. The roof and wall panels are formed in a similar way to the secondary members. In this case, we start with lighter gauge pre-painted steel coils. The steel is rolled out from these coils, cut to length, and punched as necessary for the design. The flat sheets then pass through a roll former, and a series of progressive dies form the metal to create the desired panel profiles. Trim pieces are formed using our sophisticated double folder trim brake and pre-painted flat stock. They are then securely packaged for transport in these specially designed heavy boxes. After additional parts are located, like the thousands of nuts and bolts, everything is carefully documented and loaded on Chief Carrier's flatbed trailers to be delivered to the job site, where one of 400 plus independent authorized Chief Builders, including Chief Construction, will assemble custom fabricated parts to create a new home for a manufacturer, a neighborhood church, a local retail establishment, or a warehouse to store goods.
This entire building contained 360,000 pounds of steel. It took 12 semi-trucks to deliver all the parts to the site. So that is how it is made.